Hi everyone, this is Charlie. Welcome back. I have yet again another video for you. I promise I do have some beach reads coming. I promise you, but this is going to be one of my last boring books that I have. I just finished paralegal school, for those of you who are new to the channel, or for those of you who are have been on this channel, when is he ever going to finish? I'm officially done. I wrapped up everything. I handed in all my final exams, papers, and I'm very happy. I don't know what I got yet, but I'm looking at distinction. So, all right, I'm gonna get right into it because in a previous video I had a bowl of soup that I tried to eat, and now we're not gonna go down that road. I'm sorry, Josh. It stains. Tomato soup. It stains. I should know. This book is an eye opener. Again, this is legal law related. If you want to just snooze through this, you can. Please don't, but you know what I'm trying to say. Make them go away. And just looking at this makes me want to go away. And Clint Eastwood and Christopher Reeve, and the case against disability rights about the ADA passed in 1990, which was a good year for a lot of people. I have mixed opinions about this book. I'm going to break the rule a little bit here. I'm going to rate it now. I'm giving it a 5 out of 10. I know that's harsh. There are some people who do not think the ADA is what it should be. In 2008, it was amended, of course, but this book is... copyright on this book is 2002, I believe. I think it's early 2000s. Copyright 2003. It was written by Mary Johnston, but of course Clint Eastwood. He had a mansion, and it was not ADA accessible. So, it's a federal law that was signed by President Bush in 1990, and it became part of what we call the common law, federal law, enacted by a president and other powers that be, shall we say. So, he is not, Mr. Clint Eastwood was not against the ADA, but the problem was there was no way to enforce this law that was just brand new. It was considered a brand new law. How are we going to enforce it? There were a lot of people that were all for it. There were a lot of people that were anti. But there's always the saying, nobody's against the handicap, and that's the mantra of the book. Nobody's against the handicap, but... And there's different things that they discuss about, one of them being transportation. How most buildings, especially big city building in the big cities, I can talk, schools, a lot of these places, the sidewalks, a lot of people don't know this, but the sidewalks... Even in the 60s and 70s and 80s, they didn't have that little dip on the corner. Some of them, to this day, I don't think, because they had to make it wheelchair accessible. Or for people who have walkers, you can't just, yoink, go up the... Some people can't. So, they had to do... All the cities had to be redone, all the towns. The only way to get this enforced was through litigation. And... It became a point where there were a few people who were justifiably angry, and there were other people, there were two that were mentioned, I'm not going to mention names, obviously, but two people who were just looking around, making trouble. They were paralyzed, they were wheelchair-bound, but they were slammed by lawyers, and even people who were anti-ADA, I'm sorry, who were for the ADA were like, these people are idiots. Not exactly the wording that they used, but they were making so many lawsuits and litigation and claims. Well, I can't get into your diner. I'm going to sue you. And with the provisions that this law provided, yes, it was at, you know, it being that it was brand new, if it was going to greatly affect the business, and a lot of these places, like mom and pop shops, were affected too, I think one of them went out of business. I just finished reading the book last night, and just they had to go out of business. They had to file for bankruptcy. I don't remember the whole thing exactly, but a lot of people just kept filing lawsuits. And even though it was a law, some schools, a lot of school boards, in education field, there were teachers that were like, we can't take a classroom and just knock a wall through it and make it ADA, we can't make it accessible. The mantra as well was, nobody's against the handicapped, but we want to do what we can, but we're not going to bend every single, we're not going to overturn every single stone, is what I'm trying to say. Some places were happy to do what they can do. And there were, of course, I think there was an exemption, if, like I said, if it was going to greatly affect the business, or some buildings that were pre-code or whatever, I think were excused. One woman, she was, in 1991, she was sitting for the New York bar exam. She had to have apple juice because she had a, I'm not going to go into giving too much about it, but I might as well. She was hypoglycemic, and she needed to have fluids, or she was going to have nasty headache problems, and she had to get a doctor's note saying that she was, basically the word was special, in order to sit for that bar exam. And it was 2 days, obviously. The bar exams usually last two, sometimes 3 days. On the second day, she was sitting in a separate room. Just to get the bar and become an attorney, she had to be considered special. The second day, she said, why do I have to be in here? This one woman with a lamp that they would not even let her use at another place, so they had to go here. It was just really. She said, I'm keeping my mouth shut, but this is a slap in the face to people like myself who are not special. And it was not, she wasn't being nasty about it, but she was justifiably upset. How it had to fit their criteria. Make them go away, that's the title. A lot of these people who were for the ADA, yes, personally I think it's a good law, but let me go off now and say there are so many things in it that can be unrealistic. And there were people, they were saying, maybe if we just, if they're gonna just keep banging the drum and we do, or I don't know the whole, remember the whole exact thing. Like I said, I just finished it last night, and it was a good book. But if we can't make them go away, they'll go away on their own. Or it's the, like the disabled were all banding together, and they just like get them in nicest way of saying, we love you, but get away, just go away from us. You're bothering us, normal people who can walk, talk, hold down a job. And that's very close-minded thinking. And again, public policy dictates, especially today, now we are much more ADA accommodating, we are much more friendly. There were buses that were bought for the handicap, for those who needed the wheelchairs, and the paratransit it was called, in the 1980s. There was something about that. There was the ramps. Half the buses, those ramps did not even work, or they were just frozen. They weren't. So there was a lot of wrongs that had to be righted, but the only way, like I said, was to get this law enforced, according to this book and the law itself, which I have read, is was to say, I'm suing you. Reasonable accommodations for school and work. You know, you can't have a blind person driving a bus, which was one of the what they mentioned in the book. Somebody wants to sue because they want to be a bus driver, but they can't see. And how any judge or lawyer can take that on in good conscience and say, nope, my client is perfectly fine. He can drive this bus. We don't care about the 5 million people walking around. And who knows? You want to be a school bus driver? That's great. We like that even better. Obviously, that's very dark humor. So I'm going to shut my pie hole now. But like I said, I'm giving it a five because there are some people who were just, they were bashing this law. And there were some people who were like, yes. So you had, obviously, and with most law, politics, and whatnot, public policy, this. There's very rarely this meeting of the minds. And some of the people that were just so anti-ADA were justifiably so. They would lose their entire business. They were small business owners, and you had people who were filing lawsuits just to file lawsuits, just because they could. Doesn't mean you should. So, those two people I mentioned earlier, they were literally looking for places that were like that. And that's what made me say, I can't. These people are not good. But other than that, it was a heavy read. There was another book I did earlier. I would recommend that along with this one. I would recommend this to those, especially for those who have an interest in people with disabilities, who may know somebody with a disability, and try to get to know them a little bit better. And maybe it could be a conversation starter. I don't know. It's endless. So anyway, I gotta go clean up that soup I spilled earlier. So again, as Josh would always say, for now, keep reading. And as I would always chime in, keep eating. All right, I'm gonna go get a mop.